Hello everyone, in this video let's have a look at the Evolution X ROM for the LG V30. This is based out of Android version 12 and it also has the latest Android security patch level as of now, that is 5th May 2022. So let's get started. So this is a permissive ROM like all other LG V30 ROMs, and this is the home screen. Let's have a look. So this is basically the pixel launcher, and these are the usual stuff that you see. You can search your device from the picture section, stations and app list, that kind of stuff. You can customize this as you can see here, and you also have some customization options, like you can change the wallpaper and style from here. So basically you can select from different themes, or you can even change the basic colors, like you can see here it's changed. And there's also the option to change the app grid, and you have the option for themed icons. Let me show them to you. As you can see here, these are the themed icons, but it does not work on all apps. Let's go in here. You have the settings option, and under the system settings you will find gestures. So there's one extra bug on this particular ROM that is not present on other ROMs. So let me just quickly show it to you. This is the quickly open camera app, but the bug is here. So basically when you go here, you can adjust all these settings. They work fine, and you can change the amount of gesture stuff, and you can even customize the pill length, but you cannot change and enable this full screen gestures option. It crashes the settings, and well, it simply doesn't work. You'll still have that pill at the bottom, but it is not really a big deal for me because I didn't really used to hide that, but I thought that is something you should know. And you also have the option to hide or show the IME button space beneath the keyboard. And you have some advanced gesture options, as you can see here, but I disable them because they get kind of confusing for me. So this is the press and hold power button, so you can customize and enable it for assistant, but I don't really use the assistant much, so I've disabled that. And you have swipe to take screenshot, playback control by using the volume keys, pretty dope options. And you also have the option for double tapping to check the phone, basically pause the notification, but I keep that off because I use double tap to wake. Let's go under the security section. So you can basically see that we have the face unlock option, and I have added that, and I really love that feature. So that is one of my favorite features in any ROM because it helps me to easily unlock my phone. And under the display section you have the usual stuff, and you can even extra dim your phone's brightness, but I don't really use that, so let's keep that disabled. You have the option for night light, and you can schedule or customize that, change the intensity as you can see here, but again I keep that off. And okay, so I guess I need to change it back to what I want. So we have the live display option. You can calibrate the colors here, and you can also enable the reading mode, so it keeps your eyes comfortable if you are trying to read an ebook or something. And you also have the option to double tap to wake hidden away here, and you can also enable prevent accidental wake up while the phone is in your pocket or something like that, but I didn't really feel the need for that, so I keep it off as it may cause extra battery drain. And you can enable face unlock. So basically these are two options, like when the screen is turned on, automatically do that, or when you swipe unlock screen to unlock it, then it will check for your face. You can enable this, so this is basically always on display, and you also have the ambient music ticker and that kind of stuff. So as you can see here, this is basically the pixel experience ROM, all the pixel features, but on top of that you have basically slapped some additional features which make the experience better. So you do not need to separately flash Google Apps here because they are inbuilt, and these are basically the quick settings that you find here. You can change the mic access, camera access, so basically you can enable or disable that just by flicking a button. You also have the hi-fi DAC option here. So that's pretty much it for this ROM. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos.